These pretty pink indoor vines will bring the vivid hues of nature indoors and make a wonderful addition to any house. You can cultivate these pink indoor vines to create a stunning, multicolored cascade. Let's quickly jump into the best pink vine indoor plants. Watermelon Discidia. Watermelon Discidia, also known as Discidia ovata, is a great indoor plant with leaves that resemble watermelon rinds and new growth that has a pink hue. It prefers bright, indirect light but can tolerate low light, though direct sunlight should be avoided to prevent leaf burn. Water the plant when the top 1 to 2 inches of soil are dry, being careful not to let it sit in water. High humidity is ideal, so misting or placing the plant in a more humid environment is beneficial. It does well in temperatures between 65 to 80 degrees Fahrenheit, away from cold drafts. A well-draining potting mix is best, such as one formulated for succulents. Feeding with a diluted balanced fertilizer once a month during spring and summer will support healthy growth. This plant is perfect for hanging baskets or shelves where its trailing vines can be displayed. Pink Princess Philodendron. It is a highly sought-after indoor plant known for its striking dark green leaves with vibrant pink variegation. It thrives in bright, indirect light, which helps maintain its unique pink coloring, though avoid direct sunlight as it can scorch the leaves. Water when the top inch of soil is dry, keeping the soil consistently moist but not waterlogged, as it enjoys moderate moisture. This plant prefers humidity, so misting or placing it in a more humid environment can help it thrive. It grows best in temperatures between 65 to 80 degrees Fahrenheit. A well-draining, organic-rich potting mix is ideal, and feeding it once a month during spring and summer with a balanced fertilizer will promote healthy growth. The Pink Princess Philodendron can develop a climbing habit, so it may benefit from a moss pole or stake to support its growth. With proper care, its stunning pink variegation and glossy foliage make it a standout in any indoor garden. The Rosary Vine, Ceropegia woody. It is also known as String of Hearts, is a beautiful trailing plant that's perfect for indoor spaces. It has delicate heart-shaped leaves with a unique marbled pattern, often tinged with purple. This plant thrives in bright, indirect light but can tolerate lower light levels, though growth may slow down. Allow the soil to dry out between waterings, as it is drought-tolerant and doesn't like to be overwatered. It prefers warm temperatures, ideally between 60 to 80 degrees Fahrenheit, and doesn't need high humidity. A well-draining cactus or succulent mix works best, and fertilizing once a month during the growing season can help encourage growth. This plant is perfect for hanging baskets or high shelves where its long vines can cascade down. Begonia Benigo Pink. It is a beautiful variety of begonia known for its striking pink blooms and attractive foliage. This plant thrives in bright, indirect light, making it perfect for indoor spaces. Direct sunlight should be avoided as it can scorch the leaves. Keep the soil consistently moist but not waterlogged, allowing the top inch of soil to dry out slightly between waterings. High humidity is beneficial, so misting or placing the plant near a humidifier is helpful, especially in dry environments. It grows best in temperatures between 60 to 75 degrees Fahrenheit. A well-draining potting mix, rich in organic matter, will support healthy growth. During the growing season, spring and summer, you can feed the plant with a balanced fertilizer every 2 to 4 weeks. With its vibrant pink flowers and lush foliage, Begonia Benigo Pink adds a touch of elegance to any indoor garden. Pink Calycea. It also known as Calycea repens, Pink Lady, or Pink Panther, is a trailing plant with small, delicate leaves in shades of pink, green, and purple. It's a great choice for indoor spaces due to its vibrant colors and compact growth habit. It thrives in bright, indirect light, which helps maintain its colorful foliage, though it can tolerate lower light conditions. Water regularly, but allow the soil to dry out slightly between waterings, as it prefers well-draining soil. Avoid overwatering to prevent root rot. This plant enjoys moderate to high humidity, so misting it occasionally or placing it in a more humid environment is beneficial. It prefers temperatures between 60 to 75 degrees Fahrenheit. A balanced fertilizer once a month during the growing season, spring and summer, will encourage healthy growth. Its trailing nature makes it perfect for hanging baskets, shelves, or as a colorful addition to a mixed plant arrangement. Nanoc Wandering Jew, Tradescantia albiflora, Nanoc. It's a stunning indoor plant known for its thick, vibrant leaves with pink, purple, and green stripes. It thrives in bright, indirect light, which enhances its striking colors, but can also tolerate lower light levels, though its colors may fade. Water when the top inch of soil is dry, and avoid overwatering to prevent root rot, as it prefers well-draining soil. This plant enjoys moderate humidity but can adapt to regular indoor conditions. It prefers temperatures between 60 to 75 degrees Fahrenheit. Fertilize once a month during the growing season, spring and summer, with a balanced fertilizer to promote growth. With its colorful trailing vines, the Nanoc is perfect for hanging baskets or as a vibrant, cascading accent on shelves or plant stands. Hoya Rosetta. Hoya Rosetta is a beautiful vine plant known for its slender, elongated leaves and clusters of star-shaped, fragrant flowers. It thrives in bright, indirect light, which helps promote its stunning blooms, though it can also tolerate some direct sunlight for short periods. Water the plant when the top 1 to 2 inches of soil are dry, as it prefers to dry out between waterings. Hoya Rosetta does well in moderate to high humidity, so misting or using a humidifier can be beneficial, especially in dry environments. It prefers temperatures between 60 to 85 degrees Fahrenheit and can tolerate warmer conditions. Use a well-draining potting mix, such as a cactus or orchid mix, to prevent waterlogging. Fertilizing once a month during the growing season with a balanced, diluted fertilizer will encourage growth and flowering. Its trailing vines make it perfect for hanging baskets, and its flowers add a lovely touch of elegance to any indoor space. Pink Syngonium or Syngonium podophyllum, pink, is a striking indoor plant known for its vibrant pink and green foliage. It has a vining or trailing growth habit, making it ideal for hanging baskets or elevated pots where its vines can cascade beautifully. It thrives in bright, indirect light, which helps maintain its pink coloration. While it can tolerate lower light levels, its growth may slow, and the pink hues might become less pronounced. Water the plant when the top inch of soil feels dry, as it prefers to stay consistently moist but not waterlogged. It enjoys moderate to high humidity, so regular misting or placing it in a more humid environment can help it thrive. It prefers temperatures between 60 to 80 degrees Fahrenheit. With its attractive, trailing vines and striking color, the pink Syngonium adds a vibrant touch to any indoor garden. Hoya Carnosa, often known as the wax plant, is a great choice for a vine in indoor settings. It features thick, waxy leaves and produces clusters of star-shaped, fragrant flowers. The plant is well suited to bright, indirect light but can also tolerate some direct sunlight. Water it when the top 1 to 2 inches of soil feel dry, as it prefers to dry out between waterings. It thrives in moderate to high humidity but is adaptable to typical indoor conditions. Use a well-draining potting mix, such as a blend for succulents or one mixed with orchard bark. Fertilize monthly during the growing season with a balanced, diluted fertilizer. Its trailing vines make it perfect for hanging baskets or elevated shelves, where its lush foliage and occasional blooms can be showcased. Rake's Begonia Vine, known for its strikingly colorful and patterned leaves, is not a true vine but can exhibit a trailing or sprawling growth habit. It thrives in bright, indirect light, which enhances its vibrant leaf colors, but should be protected from direct sunlight, which can scorch the leaves. Keep the soil consistently moist but not soggy, allowing the top inch to dry out between waterings. It prefers higher humidity, so regular misting or placing it in a more humid environment can be beneficial. Rake's begonias grow best in temperatures between 60 to 75 degrees Fahrenheit. Use a well-draining, organic-rich potting mix to support healthy growth. Fertilize monthly during the growing season, spring and summer, with a balanced, diluted fertilizer to promote vibrant foliage. Its attractive leaves make it an eye-catching addition to indoor spaces, especially when allowed to trail or cascade from hanging baskets or elevated pots. The Teddy Bear Vine, Cyanotis quinensis, is a charming indoor plant known for its soft, fuzzy, dark green to purplish pink inside leaves that resemble a teddy bear's fur. It thrives in bright, indirect light but can tolerate lower light conditions, though its color may become less vibrant. Water the plant when the top inch of soil is dry, ensuring the soil is well-draining to avoid waterlogging, as the plant prefers a balance between moisture and dryness. Moderate humidity is sufficient, and it grows best in temperatures between 60 to 75 degrees Fahrenheit. A regular potting mix works well for this plant, and fertilizing once a month during the growing season will help promote healthy growth. The Teddy Bear Vine has a trailing habit, making it perfect for hanging baskets or as a cascading plant in pots placed on shelves. Its soft, velvety texture and easy care nature make it a delightful addition to any indoor space. Pink indoor vines bring a splash of color and visual interest to any space, enhancing decor with their vibrant hues and unique patterns. They also thrive in typical indoor conditions, making them low maintenance.